Tens of thousands of innocent civilians have been killed, bombing our wedding parties or using cluster bomb in white phosphorus. Australia government is still follow this criminal policy in Afghanistan to put pressure on their government and let Afghan that decide their own future. No nation can donate liberation to another nation. It's better they leave Afghanistan. Years of occupation and criminal war, unfortunately, Australian government, they followed the wrong policy of the US, which is not only mockery of democracy and mockery of war on terror. This is just war crime.
When you go outside, you are not sure that you will be back safe in the house or not at night.
Australia government goes to such extent that support warlords like Malalai Joya. He's an infamous criminal that currently he's the chief of the police in Uruzgan province, where you have troops. Day by day getting more powerful and receiving $340,000 per month from Australia government, US government and other Western governments. It's better they leave Afghanistan as soon as possible. No difference between Australian troops and other occupation forces. All of them are following the same policy and betraying our people day by day. These terrorists, Taliban, warlords, Al-Qaeda, and Osama bin Laden, Gulbuddin Hekmatyar, all of them are products of the White House. And since Cold War, they had support of their foreign masters. In the Taliban time, we had one enemy, but this 10 years of occupation, we have three enemies. Warlords, Taliban occupation forces, bombing our wedding parties or using cluster bomb in white phosphorus by doing massacres, as recently they did massacre in Kandahar province and 16 civilians have been killed, that 9 of them was children. Australian people, I'm sure they agree with Afghans that no nation can donate liberation to another nation. To put pressure on their government and let Afghans that decide their own future, it's self-determination. Country which has no independence, talking about democracy, women rights, human rights, is just a painful joke.
In a country that when you do demonstration, they talk with you with the language of the gun. They throw acids on your face, put you in the jail. In back of door of your house, can you?
My message to justice-loving people of Australia, join their hands with democratic-minded activists and forces in Afghanistan. Only these democratic-minded forces can bring democracy, women rights, justice, freedom, and independence. Democracy never comes by barrel of the gun, by military invasion.